Dear students, welcome to the session on Indian classical dances. You are most welcome to this presentation on classical dances of India. As you know, among the performing arts, dance occupies a significant place. Indian dances are highly developed and stylized. They too exhibit the essence of Indian culture. Dances are performed either by individuals or groups. Dances are carried out after sadhana or rigorous and disciplined practice. Not only it is entertaining but delight the individuals or the group of audience also. They liberate you from the sorrows and worries while you witness such performances. In this episode, let us discuss very interesting details about Indian classical dances. The main objective of learning has been presented under five broad categories. They are as follows: Bharatanatyam, Kathak, Kathakali and Mohiniattam, Kuchipudi, Manipuri and Odissi. Introduction. Indian dances are classified into classical, folk and tribal. Indian classical dance was born and nourished in the temples. Later, it reached the royal courts. It is an outlet to expose one's inner feelings of joy, sorrow, anger, and also aesthetic emotions. From time immemorial, dance has its own personal spiritual touch too. Indian classical dances are based on specific rules and regulations with a definite form. They have a systematic gesture language, footwork, body movements, and rhythm. Hindu mythology is closely associated with the classical dance of India. Hindu pantheon like Shiva, Krishna, Kali and Parvati are closely associated. So the divine dances are considered as the greatest work of Indian art. Varieties of dances. Dance emerged gradually in different stages. Karana or single posture is the earliest form. There are 108 karanas associated with the dance. Different schools of dances are prevalent in India. Bharatanatyam, Kathak, Kathakali, Odissi, Kuchipudi, Manipuri and Mohiniattam are some important classical dance performances in India. Now let me explain some important classical forms. Bharatanatyam. The Devadasis were the earliest exponents of Bharatanatyam. They are the temple dancers in early South India. They perform the dance every day at the time of worship or on festive occasions. Royal dynasties like the Cholas, the Pandyas, Nayaks, Vijayanagar rulers and the Marathas patronized it. In course of time, Devadasis performed dancing in the royal courts and thus its religious sanctity was lost. Technique. The technique of Bharatanatyam consists of 64 principles of coordinated movements of hand, foot, face, and body. It is performed to the accompaniment of dance syllables. The musical instruments which accompany a dancer are Mridangam, a ghatam, a violin, a flute, and a pair of cymbals. The dance starts with a slow tempo but gathers momentum, and eventually there is a very fast movement of the hands, feet, twists of body and facial expressions. Bharatam gives importance to bhava, raga and tala. The dance commences with rita or pure dance by giving stress to timing and rhythm. Chatsura, khanda, Mishram and Sankirna are the jatis. Every one of them centers around the beat. The performance. The dance performance is executed in three different speeds. They are slow, medium and fast. Grace, speed, versatility, etc. are given importance. Lasya format. In Tamil Nadu, Bharatanatyam is practiced mainly in Lasya format. There are a number of poses. importance is assigned to the movements of body, waist, arm, hand, leg, and foot. Abhinayam comprises of facial expressions, postures, and acting. Abhinayam also centers around the talam, it is timing. The movements of different parts of the body are controlled by talam or timing. Natya Shastra. According to Natya Shastra, dance comprises of nrita or pure dance and natya, the combination of both acting and dancing. There will be methodical movements in the dance. The dances are executed on rhythmic patterns. It moves from simple to difficult forms in the specified stages. The dance comes to an end with the tirmana. At the time, the feet will move so fast and arms will take various angles and lines. Stages of execution. Alaripu is the beginning. It represents the opening of the bud into a blossom. It is rather an introduction. Invocation of the next stage of dance is called Jatiswaram. It is the combination of jati and musical notation swaram. Ragas and swaras have their own role in it. Excellent and beautiful movements of the neck, arms, gestures, feet, etc. are carried out in a captivating manner. The stepping and movements are quite absorbing. There will be swift and lovely changes of postures. Shabdam. This is the third stage. It is the pure dance movement. It has a lot of wonderful emotional acting. It is an explanation of a song or sahitya. Gesture, acting, facial expressions, etc. will find their place. The bhava, raga, and tala are introduced at this stage. This is also an introduction of the next stage, varnam. Varnam. It means color. It is the most complete stage of Bharatam. It contains elaborate dance conception, technical brilliance, richness of melody and artificial interpretation. Also, it contains an emotional acting and interpretation of a song. Natya, Nrita and Nritya are executed in its full form at this stage. Padam. It is carried out mainly to execute a smoothening attitude. The song, Pallavi, is repeated. The padams are sung in different forms with the use of several ragas such as Bhairavi, Kalyani, Kambodini, etc. Tillana. It is the final stage of dance performance. Unique postures, intricate rhythms and unison between technique and emotional acting are executed. The above mentioned stages are employed conventionally in Bharatanatyam. The performance ends with a sort of benediction. It is in the form of recitation of a short sloka. Thus, Bharatam stands as a significant aspect of the art heritage of India. Kathak. The word Kathak is derived from Katha, which means story. Also, it means a storyteller. Its origin dates back to ancient times when a band of storytellers went about reciting episodes from the Ramayana and the Mahabharata using music and dance. It soon turned into a dance drama in which actors took part. It is confined mostly to northern India, especially Uttar Pradesh, Rajasthan, Punjab, and Madhya Pradesh. The main centers are Lucknow, Banaras, Jaipur, and Delhi. The important feature of this dance is its emphasizes on footwork, the swift swirl or of the body, followed by its sudden stillness. The execution of footwork is within a time cycle. It is carried out in solo form, duets, and dance drama form. The term Kathak actually means a storyteller. This sacred aspect is adopted to express legends, folklores, and mythology. The performer will sing and dance. This renowned dance is presented in the cities of Lucknow and Jaipur. The Rajput history is depicted in the form of Kathak. It reveals their chivalrous deeds, innate love of the people for ornaments, pageantry and celebrations. Lucknow Gharane is the renowned Kathak school in India. Kathak dancer. The Kathak dancer is expected to have a sound knowledge of various aspects. The Kathak dancer moves up and down and sideways, whirls, pirouettes, punctuating each param with a perfectly timed precision. Large number of lyrics are employed in it. They are devotional and sacred. Pada, Bhajan Jatis, love lyrics, Tumri, Dadra, Ghazals are some forms of songs and musical systems employed in it. The music employed is soft and plain. Krishna legends are given top priority. The Kathak expresses a rich and dramatic Abhinaya, which is known for its technical virtuosity. Expressions are executed so beautifully. Kathak is treated as one of the significant forms of classical dances. Kathakali. Kathakali is most refined and most scientific and elaborately defined dance form of Kerala. Kathakali is not a solo dance like Bharatanatyam, but it beautifully combines music, poetry, mime, and drama. This dance drama is usually performed in open space. It is a specialized form of dance. It takes place only during nights after dinner. It is performed on a sketchy stage under the canopy of a star-spangled sky lit by great shining brass oil lamps. The themes are taken from Ramayana, the Mahabharata, and Hindu mythology. The Kathak costumes show a great variety of color. The musical instruments are quite simple, viz. Drums and cymbals. The actors put on masks of various types to represent deities or the demons. It is a devotional and sacred art. Ethical and Puranic stories have also inspired this art. It is popular in Kerala from the 17th century onwards. It is known for its dance technique, dramatic acting, powerful expressions, religious fervor, and pantomime mark. It has its own special characteristics. This performance is inspired by the beauty of the natural surroundings of Kerala. During the time of festivals, Kathakali performances are conducted. Hastalakshana Deepika offers a vivid account about the rules and regulations of Kathakali. The features of Kathakali: Bhava or mood, Raga or melody of the song, and Tala and the rhythmic timing play their role in Kathakali also. Much importance is assigned to dramatic interpretations and rhythmic time measures. Talams and the jatis are adopted in Kathakali. Syllabic rhythmic words are employed in Kathakali. The use of eye, eyebrows, neck, hands, etc. are important for expressions. Training. The Kathakali performer carries out this program only after undergoing intensive training for a period of 12 years. So the training commences usually at the age of 10. Mostly men are taking part in Kathakali performance. Feminine characters are also taken up by young, handsome men. So the performer will be an expert and a dedicated artist. But nowadays, in urban cities, even girls and women take part in it. This dance drama is enacted with an accompaniment of music. The stories are shown in the form of pattus, consisting of shlokas, and padams. They are in the form of dialogues. Songs used are in the form of Carnatic music. The drums occupy a unique place in this performance. Chenda is a kind of drum used, which is also called Kelikuttu. Madala, a large drum, is also used. After the invocation song, the curtain will be removed and the performance will commence. This is known as Purappadu. Excellent movements are made according to the sound produced by the drums and conches. The intricate footwork, bodily posture, and spreading of legs and standing on the edges of feet are carried out. Melappadam. Subsequently, Melappadam or drumming starts. The episodes from Puranas and epics are all depicted. This Tandava style of dance is captivating. The singer by his songs leads the dancers. There will be a harmony between the melody, rhythm of singing and the performance of the art. Mohiniyattam. It is also a classical dance of Kerala. The word Mohini literally means a maiden who is capable of stealing the heart of the onlooker. In format, this is similar to Bharatanatyam. The movements are graceful like Odissi. The costumes are sober and attractive. It is essentially a solo dance. Kuchipudi. Kuchipudi is a classical dance of Andhra Pradesh. It emerged from Kuchilapuram village in Krishna district. This dance drama has a long period of history. The comprehensive principles and the techniques are mostly classical in nature. Emotions are highlighted through stories. Features of Kuchipudi. The Kuchipudi dance dramas are known for their devotional approaches. They are performed in temples at times of festivals. In due course, the drama obtained the name of Bhamakalapam. Importance to Abhinaya or emotional aspects are given. The classical technique or Nratha is also included in it. So the Kuchipudi dance had the elements such as Natya and Nritya. It gives importance to the movement of the body, hands and limbs in union with one another. The eyes and eyebrows also speak. Abhinaya or emotional acting is given importance. Daruvas. The introduction of the dance is called Daruvas. The dancers as well as the musicians introduce the artist. The sabdas in the introduction of the dramatic lyric. Abhinaya gives importance to four varieties such as Angikabhinaya, expression through body, Vachikabhinaya, expression through voice, Sattarikabhinaya, expression through feelings, and Aharyabhinaya, expression through dress. Raga, Bhava, and Tala are given due importance. The foot movements are made according to rhythms. Stress is also given to Karana. It is a tradition that only men should be engaged in Kuchipudi. The role of women characters are also undertaken by young men. The movements are gracious. The role of the stage director is very important. Bhamakalapam, Gollakalapam are certain important themes adopted in Kuchipudi. Alarippu, Jatiswaram, Sabdam, Varnam, Padam too find their place in it. Manipuri. This dance belongs to the state of Manipur in northeast India. Manipuri is purely a religious dance which is used to invoke divine blessing. This is very much a ritualistic dance associated with Shiva and Parvati. After 15th century, Vaishnavite themes are also included. The concept of Krishna and Radha also became prominent. Saivite theme. Manipuri as a classical dance has its own fine traditions and philosophical contents. Imphal, the capital of Manipur, is the prime center of this dance. It has its own religious and ceremonial rules. The Manipuri dance centers around legendary and mythical themes. This dance performance is associated with Shiva and Parvati. Lai Haroba is one of the famous dance dramas of that place. There is another legendary dance in the name Lisam Jagoi. Chappa, Kongle and Mairang dances are the other popular forms. Vaishnavite theme. After the 15th century, Vaishnavite themes are also penetrated into the Manipuri dance. The concept of Krishna became predominant. The Manipuri dance is systemized and codified due to the involvement of various gurus. The popular maestros in Manipuri are Guru Bipin Sinha, Javeri Sisters and T. Nadia Singh. Features of Manipuri. It is best known for their beauty, rich content and religious sentiments. They are performed with specific rules and strict disciplines during the times of social ceremonies and religious festivals. It offers importance to gesture, abhinaya and expression. It stresses the harmonious blending of bhava, raga, tala and natya. Two styles. It contains lasya, it is graceful style, and tandava, the forceful style. They are amenable to specific sets of rules and regulations. It has certain free movements also. Chali is the traditional dance composition used in lasya and tandava dances. Tilana, swaramala, chaturanga are the other aspects associated with Manipuri dance. Group dances. In Manipuri, rasakas or group dances are also important. Tal rasaka, danda rasaka and mandala rasaka are popular. Rajlilas. On special occasions, six types of Rajlilas are performed. They are Maharaj, Vasantaraj, Kunjaraj, Nityaraj, Goparaj, etc. Kartal Cholam, Manjira Cholam, Pung Cholam are few other dance performances of Manipur. They are known for their grace and exhibition of emotions. Manipur dancers are known for beautiful costumes used at the time of performances. They are delicate and captivating. Odissi of Odisha. It is a classical dance of Orissa. It is considered to be the oldest form of classical dance dating back to pre-Christian era. Odissi is built on the principle that the human body is meant to be employed in deflection. The main emphasis is on the status process of the dancer. Thus, the characteristic of the Odissi style is the bhanga or breaking of the human body with deflection of the head, the torso and the hips. The dress contains of a bright colored sari hanging loosely and a tight fitted blouse. The musical instruments accompanying the dance performances are a drum, a pair of cymbals, a flute and a stringed instrument. The format consists of Bhumi Prana, Batu Pallavi and lighter items like the Ashtapadi ending in Moksha approximating to the Tillana of the South. Other classical dances. This category includes the other equally important forms of dance with their distinct tradition and style. In this connection, let me mention about the Bhagavata Mela Nataka of Tanjore, Krishnattam of Kerala, Satriya of Assam, Ottan Tullal and Koodiyattam of Kerala and Chau of Mayurbhanj and Purulia. To sum up, classical dances are essentially based on well-defined traditional disciplines. Though Bharatanatyam originated from Tamil Nadu, later on it has been embraced throughout India. Kathakali has its roots in Kerala, is sometimes referred to as dance, but essentially is not. Kathak has Hindu and Islamic influences. It was particularly popular with the Mughals. It was restored as a serious art form in the early 20th century. Manipuri has a delicate, lyrical flavor, hails from Manipur. Kuchipudi is a 17th century drama originated from Andhra Pradesh village, from which it takes its name. The story centers of envious wife of Krishna. Of late, to attract domestic and international tourists, several events are organized, which is very popular and draws large number tourists to this well-organized events. Thank you.